four, three, two.
Hurricanes, welcome back to another electrifying episode of The Hurricane. I'm Caitlin Blandon, and I'm amped to dive into all the awesome segments we've got lined up for you today.
What's up, everyone? I'm Emma Cortez, and buckle up because this week's show is going to be a whirlwind of excitement, laughter, and some serious school spirit.
First up, it's the Chubby Bunny Challenge. Who's brave enough to stuff their mouth with marshmallows and take on the tongue-twisting task of saying Chubby Bunny?
You know the drill, Hurricanes. Grab your marshmallows, brace for some hilarious moments, and let's see who will be crowned the Chubby Bunny Champion this time.
All right, so for today's segment, we're going to do a Chubby Bunny Challenge. But I know Chubby Bunny has been around for like a couple years already. You guys already seen everything. So today, we're just going to do a little bit of a twist on it. So for every marshmallow you get in your mouth and say Chubby Bunny, you get 25 cents. So four marshmallows, a dollar, and so on. But the catch is, if you don't complete the dollar, so let's say you get to $1.75 and you can't get the fourth one in to make it $2, you lose the dollar and you just go to $1. So that's what the catch is, and let's just go see if other people want to do it.
The vocabulary.
Oh, yeah.
I'm here with
Aiden Grace,
Kristen,
and they're going to be competing in Chubby Bunny.
Chubby Bunny. Chubby Bunny.
Chubby Bunny.
Chubby Bunny.
Chubby Bunny.
Chubby Bunny.
Chubby Bunny.
Chubby Bunny.
Chubby
Bunny. Chubby Bunny. Chubby Bunny. Chubby Bunny.
Chubby Bunny. Chubby Bunny.
Chubby Bunny. Chubby Bunny. Chubby Bunny. Chubby Bunny. Chubby Bunny. Chubby Bunny.
$1 for $2.
$2 again.
Oh my god.
Chubby Bunny, bro. Put it in. Say it. You
got it. I'm here with
Xavier.
And I'm here with
Chase.
And they're going to be competing in Chubby Bunny. So, go ahead.
It's just put one in the mouth.
Yep. Chubby Bunny.
Chubby Bunny.
Chubby Bunny.
Oh, then he's
Chubby Bunny.
Chubby Bunny.
There you go.
Chubby Bunny.
Oh, he's stepping there.
Chubby Bunny.
Chubby Bunny.
How many?
Chubby Bunny.
Chubby Bunny.
Keep going, bro. Keep going. Chubby Bunny.
Chubby Bunny. Alright, you have $2 right now. How many do you have?
Chubby Bunny.
You can get four more, huh?
Four more.
Chubby Bunny. Chubby Bunny.
Keep going, bro.
Chubby Bunny. Who gets the last one? Oh, there's one more.
Get the last one.
Oh, no.
Hold back.
Chubby Bunny.
Who won?
How many you got?
What?
You got seven. How many you got?
Oh my god.
You got eight.
Are you in?
How many did he get?
He got eight. Chase won.
Oh wait, why? I thought you said he got nine.
No, I thought I got eight.
Oh.
I think both got eight.
Oh,
they tied.
Let's shift gears from marshmallow madness and some adrenaline-pumping action. Our Hurricane football team has been making waves on the field, and we've got the epic highlights from their latest showdown.
Get ready to be blown away, folks. Touchdowns, tackles, and that unbeatable team spirit, our Hurricanes have it all. Get your Hurricane flags ready as we relive the jaw-dropping moments on the field.
To shine the spotlight on one of our amazing educators, and this week's teachers features, we're diving into the world of Miss Rent, our passionate Spanish teacher who's sparking curiosity and igniting minds.
Get ready to learn some fascinating facts about Mrs. Rents. She's awesome.
I'm here with
Mrs. Rents.
I have a couple questions for you. Is that okay?
That's fine.
Why did you become a teacher?
Because I really love kids. I just can't imagine myself doing anything else.
What do you love about teaching?
The relationships with my students. That's the best part about it. I enjoy teaching Spanish. Spanish is a lot of fun to teach, but it's the relationships that I build with the kids in my classroom that makes it worthwhile.
What don't you like about teaching?
Some of the behavior issues present challenges sometimes, but not too bad.
What would you do if you weren't a teacher?
I would probably be some kind of therapist, I think, like a counselor or a psychologist.
All right, that's all the questions we have for you. Thank you for your time.
Thank you.
Let's switch things up a bit now with a segment that's all about transformation, the haircutting segment. We have a brave volunteer, Stone Nation. He is ready to revamp his hairstyle and will be there every snip of the way.
From daring chops to stylish trims, you won't believe the incredible before and after shots. It's all about fresh starts and new looks.
All right, Kane's Vision, this is DR, and here I have Stone Nation. And today, last time we cut Stone's hair, we gave him kind of a taper on the side and just the back. But today, Stone said he wanted to switch it up a bit, give him a bit of flair. And he actually wanted to go with a burst fade instead, which is something new for him. And hopefully he can leave here satisfied with the new cut he got.
Let's go. Bro, if you mess me up, I'm gonna have eyewitness account.
Camera witness. All right, so as you can see right here, we're gonna fade up this part right here. But Stone has a lot of hair that just hangs over and droops over right here. So we're gonna have to cut a lot of this off so I can like just debulk this and actually start fading.
Let's go. I already voted for you.
We're voting again?
There's three votes.
Lou, I voted for you, but I don't think you're gonna win, dog.
Why'd your parents name you Stone?
Gotta keep that under wraps, bro. It has secret meaning.
Secret?
Yeah.
Like Illuminati secrets?
Like awesome James Bond. Imagine if I was tan, would it look good? Like my scalp was tan.
Yeah.
What'd you say?
Bye.
That's what I'm saying, like...
Dude, my forearm is killing me.
Why?
Because I can't squirt. There's so much water.
Why'd you soak my hair?
I was waiting for you to say something. That took
I
too
did
long.
Say something, you ignored me.
Bro, I wasted the whole thing.
Look how wet my hair is right now.
And after the finishing touch, someone has all this junk back here. We have to line up. So we're just going to line it up in a V segment from the back. Can you kind of see mine? I guess. But I told her I'm a loner. But she likes my watch and my drop top and my persona. We hit the highway 155 with my whole foot on the dash. She's in my ear, she's got no fear. She could care less if we crash. But on my radar, I've got some nerve to play hard. I waited for my chance. We're playboys, we don't dance. That's my heart. Speed.
She took my heart, filled it with nothing
about to see his new
Let's see
haircut.
How I like it.
Let's see how he likes
it. Oh yeah!
He starts crying.
Woo! We got that signature V style.
Sideways, look at the back. Look at the texture you have in the back.
Oh my God, that's a lot of texture. Look at. I think that wraps up episode 2. Let's go.
Quick announcement. There will be a meeting for all of those interested in joining swim team on Friday, September 8th, immediately after school in Mrs. Wren's room, M202.
Hello, my name is Cohen Tanner, and this is your weekly sports update. On Tuesday, the softball team beat Calhoun 6-5. Also on Tuesday, the volleyball team went 2-0 in their set against Model and won. Last Friday, the Cartersville Hurricanes took on Jonesboro Cardinals, and they won that game 24-13.
380.
This Friday, the Hurricanes take on Allatoona High School at home at 7:25. The theme is USA, be there and show out. Let's go, Hurricanes.
I'm here with
Maddox Frazier,
Nate Russell. We both play football and baseball.
I started playing football my freshman year of high school.
Started playing in first grade.
My inspiration is Connor Foster.
Mine would probably be Joe Burrow. My father.
Yeah, I would have to say my dad too. Coach Gordon, definitely.
Miss Terry.
All the memories and all the stuff we do as a team, like team bonding and all the coaches.
Yeah.
And like Friday Night Lights. Definitely.
Yeah, definitely like the team camaraderie. A lot of the stuff we get to do together. All that's real fun. Obviously, games are fun. Yeah. Plant the flag, you know what I'm saying? Go 15-0, but yeah.
I'd say try to win a state championship, you know, and beat Warner Robins of our losing record to them.
It can be, like, time management, like, sometimes you get home at, like, 7:45, 8 o'clock, and, like, still got to do homework and stuff. And that can be hard to manage.
Yeah, like, your sleep schedule's really messed up because some days you have, like, 5 a.m. You have to wake up, like, 5 for morning practice. And then, like, this week we had 2 morning practices, one today and one yesterday. So you have to go to bed pretty early for that.
And that's a wrap on another action-packed episode of
The Hurricanes.
Thanks for tuning in, Hurricanes. Until next time, stay pumped, stay proud, and keep riding the hurricane of school spirit.